Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to the lecture number 18 on Bode plots. We have finished how to construct the Bode plot, including the magnitude plot as well as the phase plot in our last lecture. Today, we are going to solve one problem. We are going to take one example to construct the Bode plot. So, straight away, let me take one example. This was also a request from the group that at least there should be one example, and so that there is a clear the clear-cut guidelines can be made to construct the Bode plot. Moreover, we have completed our internal evaluation, that is class test 1, followed by 3 assignments of 15 marks. So the internal evaluation of 25 marks as well as the mid-semester marks is communicated to you through the email. And if you have any issues, I assume that you have put a mail to me mentioning your mobile number also. Now let us start with an example on the Bode plot. So I am going to take one open loop system, that is G of S, H of S open loop system, and the transfer function is 512 S plus 3 divided by S into S square plus 16S plus 256. So if you are getting open loop transfer function, don't start constructing the Bode plot straight away. Look into the transfer function carefully. Look into that whether the transfer function is in the time constant form or not. Important, look at this second order term. This second order term, you should start thinking that can I have the factors of this? If you get the roots, real roots of this second order term, then that is no longer a second order term, okay? It is the combination of two first order terms. But the second order terms means the roots are complex conjugate. So if the roots are real, then you need to factorize this. And if the roots are complex, then and then only it would be a second order term. So please, for example, there is a term like this, S square plus 3S plus 2. Okay, this is no longer a second order term because S square plus S plus 2S plus 2. Like if I take S common, then S plus 1. If I take 2 common, then S plus 1. Then S plus 2 and S plus 1 are the factors. So now this term is S plus 1 into S plus 2. It is no longer a second order term. It is the combination of two first order terms. So if the roots are real, then they are no longer, then that term is no longer a second order term. So please keep in this mind. So before starting any sketching the root locus, you need to analyze the second order terms. Okay. The second order term will be called only when it is the roots are in the complex conjugate form. This was very important. People are doing mistake here. They straight away consider it as a second order term. So here it is no clear cut. The roots are complex conjugate, so it is a second order term. In your assignments also, there are actually all the students have done a mistake in writing the terms. So if you are writing, how many terms are there? So there is one term known as 512. There is one term known as S plus 3. There is one term known as 1 by S. There is one term known as 1 by S square plus 16S plus 256. So you have to write 1 by S. You have to write 1 by this. Okay. Don't write S square plus 16S plus 256 straight. It is not this. There is a difference between S square plus 16S plus 256 and there is a difference between this. See, it is a numerator term, okay? And this is a denominator term. So don't write S as only one S term. It is 1 by S term. Unless and until S in the numerator, then only it is the single term S. So this is also you need to keep in your mind. Almost everybody has done a mistake in the assignment. Alright. So first of all, you should convert this transfer function into a time constant form. Okay. Time constant form. So 512, if I take 3 common here, then s by 3 plus 1 tau s plus 1 form, okay, then s, if I take, let's say, 256 common, because the coefficient of s s to 0 should be 1, so s square by 256 plus 16 by 256 s plus 1, okay, so this into 2 into 3, 6, so now the time constant form is g of s, h of s should be equal to 6 into s by 3 plus 1 divided by s into s square by 256 plus 16 by 256 s plus 1. So this is the time constant form now. Now whatever the constant left after converting into time constant form, that is your steady state gain. Okay, this is k, which is steady state gain. So if you able to compute this correctly, then and then only the next steps would be correct. All right. Now you need to find the corner frequencies. So you don't have corner frequency for the constant term. For this term, s by 3 plus 1, this term, the corner frequency would be 1 by tau. So this is tau s plus 1. Tau is 1 by 3. So tau is equal to 1 by 3. So the corner frequency is 1 by tau. Okay, 1 by tau is nothing but 3. So the corner frequency is 3. For 1 by s, there is no corner frequency. Okay. And for this term, 1 upon s square plus 2 by 256, 16 by 256 s plus 1. For this term, corner frequency is omega n, omega n. So omega n square was 256. So omega n square was 256. So omega n is 16. So the corner frequency is 16. Okay. So there are two corner frequencies. One is 3, another is 16. So now you need to arrange this in the ascending order. So first is 3, then it is 16. Smallest to largest. So corner frequencies are 3 and 16. 3 is coming from the numerator. 16 is coming from the denominator of second order term. 3 is coming from the numerator of first order term. Okay. Please keep this in mind. All right. Now comes the initial slope line. Initial slope line from where the magnitude plot starts. So that initial slope line is having slope of, it depends upon the type of the system. Depends upon type of the system. So, since it is type 1 system, because there is a pole at origin, or there is one pole at origin, then it is minus 20 dB per decade. If it is S square, then minus 40 dB per decade. If S rest to 0 means there is no pole at origin, then it is parallel 0 dB line, okay, dB per decade slope. And if it is in the numerator, then plus 20 dB per decade. If this S is in the numerator, then plus 20. If S square in the numerator, then plus 40 dB per decade. Okay. So the slope contribution from poles is negative. The slope contribution from zeros is positive. Slope contribution for first order denominator is minus 20. First order numerator is plus 20. Second order denominator is minus 40. Second order numerator then it is plus 40 dB per decade. All right. So this is one thing. Now this initial slope line crosses 0 dB line at omega is equal to k. Okay. If it is second order term, then omega is equal to root of k. This is first type 1. Okay. This is for type 2 system. So since it is type 1 system, it will cross, that initial slope line will cross the 0 dB axis at omega is equal to k. And k was 6. So at omega is equal to 6. So far, so we have calculated the cone of frequencies were 3 and 16, and initial slope line was minus 20 dB per decade, and it will cross the 0 dB line at omega is equal to k, that is 6. These three informations we need to calculate initially. Now we can prepare the table. So table was having terms, then corner frequencies, then slope contribution, then final slope. Okay, this is the table. All right. So the term is 6. There is no cone of frequency, there is no slope contribution, and there is no final slope, okay? Because it doesn't contribute any slope. Then we have, so now you need to check the cone of frequencies, okay? In the ascending order, 3 is coming from, we need to check this also, 1 by S first. So 1 by S, if it is type 1 system, type 0 system, 1 by S term. Cone of frequency, there is no cone of frequency. Slope contribution is minus 20 dB per decade. Why? Because it is first order term. So final slope would be minus 20 dB per decade. Okay. So, yeah. Okay. Then comes 3. So, first you should take all the components, all the terms where there is no cone of frequency. Okay. Now you start from the ascending order. 3. 3 is coming from S by 3 plus 1. So this term is S by 3 plus 1. This is the term. Here the cone of frequency is tau S plus 1. So 1 by tau. 1 by tau is 3. Since it is the first order term, so slope contribution would be 20. It is the numerator term. So plus 20 dB per decade. So, minus 20, earlier it was minus 20, plus 20, now it is 0 dB per decade. Okay, this term is over. So, initially minus 20, then 0 dB per decade. Now comes 16. 16 is coming from the second order term, this term. And divided by, 1 upon this, okay? 1 upon this. 1 upon this term. Cone of frequency is 16. Slope contribution. Since it is a second order denominator term, so minus 40 dB per decade. So earlier slope was 0, minus 40. So minus 40 dB per decade. All right. So we have prepared the table now. So how the magnitude plot will look like? So there would be, initially the slope would be minus 20. Then the slope is 0 dB. Then the slope is minus 40 dB per decade. This is how the magnitude plot will vary. The slope of the magnitude plot will vary. Now, initially the slope was minus 20. It will continue till omega, the next cone of frequency omega is equal to 3. Okay. So omega is equal to 3, the slope would be 0. It will continue at 0 dB till omega is equal to 16. After omega is equal to 16, the slope would be minus 40 degree per decade. Okay. So the slope is changing at the corner frequencies, that is 3 and 16. So this is, you should remember this table. All right. Now let us prepare we will see how the magnitude plot will look like. But before that, because we need to draw both the plots, the phase plot and the magnitude plot simultaneously. So let us prepare the phase plot now. So for the phase plot, we need to write the phase equation. That is, phase equation is equal to phi. Phi is equal to, okay. This is nothing but G of S, H of S. So phase phi is equal to, this constant term doesn't contribute anything, okay, on the phase. So what about this? This term, this is numerator term, so positive. So tan inverse of, now I need to replace S by J omega, okay. So I'm replacing S is equal to J omega. S is equal to J omega. S is equal to J omega. Okay. So this is nothing but G of J omega, H of J omega. And I need to calculate the phase. Okay. Which is nothing but G of J omega, H of J omega. Is equal to this. So tan inverse of any complex term. B by tan inverse of B by A. B is nothing but omega by 3. By 1, so it is omega by 3. So it is plus, okay, because it is due to the numerator. Then this term, 1 by s term, the slope is minus 90 degree, okay, because of this, minus pi by 2, because of this, minus tan inverse of this. Now what about this term? This term can be written as j square is minus omega square upon 256. Plus 1, this term, plus 16 by 256 omega j. So this is nothing but a plus b j, okay, in this form. What is a? A is this. What is b? B is this. Okay, so tan inverse of b, b is 16 by 256 omega by a is this. So, if I take this, so 256 minus omega square divided by 256, okay? So, this 256 get cancelled. So, tan inverse of 16 omega divided by 256 minus omega square. This is the phase equation. All right. Note down, this is minus, this is also minus because due to the denominator, this is plus because due to the numerator term. So this is the phase of angle of G of J omega, H of J omega. Now I need to prepare the phase table. So phase table is omega and phi. Okay. So you need to have different values of omega you need to put here in this equation. Okay. To get the values of phi. So I have already calculated and I'm writing. So what is the lowest corner frequency? The lowest corner frequency is 3. Okay, lowest corner frequency is 3. So 1 decade ahead. So 3 is 0.3. So you can start from 0.1. Okay. So 0.1. It is minus 88.46 degree. Okay. Then you can say 0.2. Let's say 0.2 is minus, you can check this, it is 6.92. You have to replace omega is equal to 0.1 in this equation to get the value of phi. Then you have 1, let's say, then minus 75.16 degree. Okay. Then you have 2, let's say, minus 63.53 degree. Okay. Then you have 5, it is minus 50.1 degree, okay, then you have tan, you have minus 62.4 degree, okay, then omega versus phi, okay, you have 20, let's say, so minus 122.7. Now here, very important thing, when you take omega is equal to 16, so 16 square is 256, 256 minus 256 would be 0, your calculator will give wrong answer, okay, so you need to add minus 180 degree here, okay, when the omega is more than 16 degree. So when omega goes from 10 to 20, your calculator will give wrong answer. Okay, actually you need to see the quadrant where it is positive. So you have to add minus 180 degree when the omega is more than 16 degree. Okay, here. So please keep this in mind. Your calculator make give incorrect answer. Okay, please be careful when omega is more than 16 degree. So then 100 omega, so it is minus 172.4. So almost I have finished, because my corner frequency was 3, so 1 decade behind it is 0.3, so I have started from 0.1, then the corner frequency is 16, so the decade will end up to 100, so I have taken up to 100, okay. So this is the phase table. You need to remember this because you need to plot in the phase plot. All right. So now we have all the information about the magnitude plot and the phase plot with us. And now let us sketch this, the root locus. Okay. So for that, let's say this is 0 dB line, okay. Let's say this is 20 dB. Let's say this is 40 dB. Let's say this is minus 20 dB, okay. And now there are cycles, okay. So let's say this is 0.1, this is 0.1 frequency, 1 decade, so 1, this is 10, and let's say this is 100, okay, and this axis is known as log of W. So this is a log scale, 0.1, 1, 10, 100, okay, alright, now, we will sketch the magnitude plot first. To sketch the magnitude plot, I need the initial slope line. So we know that the slope of the initial line was minus 20 dB per decade. But that line crosses the 0 dB axis. This is 0 dB axis. At omega is equal to k, and k was 6. So I need to identify 6 first. So this is 1, this is 2, this is, let's say this is 3, this is 4, this is 5, this is 6. So 6 is here, okay? 6 is here. Okay? K is equal to 6. Okay? Omega is equal to 6. Out. Now, I need to draw a line of minus 20 dB per decade slope, which is passing through this 6 that we have studied in our earlier lectures. So, 6, then 0.6 would be here. 1 decade and 20 dB here, so this, okay, up, 20 dB up. So now if I join this line, this line is having the slope of minus 20 dB per decade and passing through 6. Once again, to draw a line of the slope minus 20 dB per decade, what should I do, which is passing through 6, then 1 decade here, so it is 0.6, this is 0.6, okay, 6.6, go 20 dB up, because the slope is minus 20 dB, up, and join this 2 point, because this is 20, okay, then this line is having the slope of minus 20 degree per decade. Alright. So this is known as the initial slope line. This is known as initial slope line. Kitna slope? Minus 20 dB per decade. Okay? Passing through 6. So now the initial slope line is minus 20 dB per decade. It will have the slope minus 20 dB per decade till the first corner frequency. The first corner frequency is 3. It is 3. Okay? So now I will take this and I will mark this point. So this is the corner frequency 3. So now this is the initial slope line, and now I will make this line bold. Okay, this is the slope of having minus 20 dB per decade. Now after 3, if you look into the table, the first corner frequency, the slope is 0 dB per decade. So the slope is parallel till the next corner frequency. So after this, the line is parallel, okay? Because 0 dB per decade. Okay. Now the slope is changing at corner frequency. And that slope is 0 dB per decade. So this is 0 dB per decade line. It is parallel line till the next corner frequency. Next corner frequency is 16. So this is 10. This is 20, this is 30, and this is 100, okay? 16 is somewhere here, okay? So this is 16, okay? So now you bold this line up to this. Okay, so the slope here is 0 dB per decade, okay? And from 16, the slope is minus 40 dB per decade, if you look into the table. So now you need to draw a line from the passing from this point, and the slope is minus 40. So what should you do? 16, go to 1.6, let's say here. 1.6 is here, okay? Yeah, somewhere here, one decade here. It is 16, 1.6 here, and go from this point, let's say if I want, you can go ahead also. So 16 to 160 would be somewhere here. Go 40 dB down from this point, okay? Or 40 dB up from this point, okay? If you go down, then let's say 40 here. And now you join these two lines. This is minus 40 dB per decade line, okay?
Yeah.
And you make this bold. So what is magnitude plot? Magnitude plot is this plot. This is the magnitude plot. What is gain crossover frequency? Gain crossover frequency is this, where the gain plot crosses the 0 dB axis. So this is omega GC, gain crossover frequency. Okay. Now you draw the phase plot. So now the phase plot, so you need to draw a minus 180 degree line. So this is, let's say, minus 180 degree, okay? You say minus 150, minus 130, minus 120, this is minus 90, let's say this is minus 60, okay, degree. So you have a scale of 30, so minus 180, and this is nothing but minus 210 degree, okay? So minus 210, minus 180, minus 150, you can take any scale this. Now you draw the phase plot. You have a phase equation with you and you have a phase table. So omega is equal to 0.1. Omega is equal to 0.1, 88.46. So 88.46 would be somewhere here. So it would be here. Then 0.2, 86.92. It would be up. 0.1, 0.2 would be here. This, okay. So now, if I draw this phase plot, it would be something like here. Then, up to 5, so 1, 5 would be here, somewhere here. 5 angle would be 50 degrees, so here, okay? So now, if you join all these points, this, the graph is something like this. If you plot all these phase, okay? Yeah. This is the phase plot. Now, once you have the magnitude plot and the phase plot, okay, what is omega PC? That is phase crossover frequency. You can see that this phase plot never crosses minus 180 degree line. It may crosses infinite, okay? So, omega phase crossover frequency is infinite, okay? Because it is not crossing the minus 180 degree line. You can see this. Okay, it would be at infinite. I don't know right now, but it would be infinite. All right. Now, I need to find the gain margin and the phase margin. So, to find the phase margin first, I need to project omega GC. Omega GC is projected on the phase plot, okay? So, here, it is projected here. Okay. So, this, you need to check it here. So, phase plot is around 40 degree. Phase margin is around, this is around 40 degree, okay? So, phase margin is roughly equal to 40 degree. It may be differ, okay? Because this is a rough sketch, not to the scale. What is gain margin? So, gain margin, I need to find the omega PC, but omega PC is infinite. So, let us say that omega PC is infinite. At infinite, it crosses this, maybe somewhere here or maybe at infinite, and then this distance is infinite actually, okay? Because at infinite, this plot will go to infinite, and so therefore, gain margin is infinite. So, phase margin is positive. Why it is positive? Because it is above minus 180 degree line. This is above minus 180 degree line. And gain margin is infinite because it is below the 0 dB axis. So, this would be this. So, system is stable. This is how we can check the stability of the system. For any value of k, the system will going to remain stable. So, with this, the example is over. Thank you.